You're on a subway, and suddenly, you come across someone with a long face, big nose, low skull, and prominent brow ridge. You'd probably figure out right away that they are Neanderthals because of their distinct appearance. Our closest extinct cousins were way different from modern anatomical humans. But how? And more importantly, why? In this video, we're stepping into the world of Neanderthals to find out what made them absolute units of their time. So, around 600,000 years ago, anatomical modern humans, or AMH, shared their daily life with Neanderthals. Our now extinct cousins evolved into Western Eurasia and adapted into the cold and temperate climates of Europe and parts of Asia. AMH, our ancestors, evolved in Africa, where they adapted to warmer and more diverse climates. The earliest evidence of AMH dates back around 315,000 years, with traits gradually evolving over time. As they spread out of Africa and into Europe around 43,000 years ago, AMH began to replace Neanderthals, who eventually became extinct around 40,000 years ago. The difference in environments and evolutionary paths led to distinct physical and behavioral characteristics between the two species. And even though they are not our lookalikes, we contain around 2% of their genome as a result of interbreeding. Remember that someone from the subway? Well, the first thing you'd notice about their appearance is their sloping forehead and those large arched brow ridges. Their nose would be wider and more pronounced than what we're used to. And their skull would appear a bit more elongated. From a side view, the differences become even clearer. Neanderthals had noticeably smaller chins and much larger front teeth compared to us. Their skull is a major point of differentiation. AMH tended to have a high or rounded skull, while Neanderthals had a long and low skull, similar to other early humans. But it was not just the skull. Neanderthals also boasted slightly larger brains. It was about 1,400 cubic centimeters on average, while the brain size of modern humans is around 1,300 cubic centimeters. Another unique feature of Neanderthal skulls is the occipital bun, a bony projection at the back of the head and a small depression in the middle of this area, known as the subpharynx fossa. But its purpose is still a bit of a mystery. Even their ear bones have a different shape, adding another layer of distinction between them and modern humans. A significant element that makes us different from our extinct cousins is height. Neanderthals were slightly shorter, but significantly heavier than their AMH counterparts from the Paleolithic era. Males typically stood between 1.62 and 1.66 meters tall, with females slightly shorter, around 1.52 to 1.57 meters. But hey, what they lacked in height, they made up for in sheer bulk. Their bodies were muscular and robust, with broad chests, wide pelvises, and very strong limbs. With a body mass that was about 10 to 25% higher than their modern counterparts. An average Neanderthal could weigh around 78 to 82 kilograms for males and 66 kilograms for females. This suggests that they were lean but muscular due to their active lifestyles and diets. Their build was particularly noticeable when compared to the earliest AMH in Eurasia, whose longer limbs were more similar to modern African populations. But it's not just the anatomy that made Neanderthals an amazing species. Their growth was also fast-paced. Neanderthals matured at a much younger age compared to early humans. Their teeth, for instance. Remains discovered in a Croatian cave led scientists to conclude that Neanderthal teeth started emerging up to 4 months earlier than in modern humans. This early dental emergence suggests that Neanderthal infants were weaned off sooner than Homo sapiens and transitioned to solid foods at a much younger age. Their rapid development was likely necessary to meet the high energy demands of their large brains and active lifestyle. But why were they so different? It can logically be explained with the ecographical rule proposed by Bergman. This rule suggests that mammals in colder environments tend to have larger body mass to reduce heat loss by lowering their surface area to volume ratio. Because of their distinct evolutionary environment, living in the cold, harsh climates of Ice Age Europe, Neanderthals needed to conserve heat. Their shorter limbs and stocky build reduced the surface area exposed to the cold and helped them retain warmth. Their large noses and prominent frontal sinuses were also adaptations to the cold, helping to warm and humidify the frigid air they breathed. Think of them as the human equivalent of a winter coat, thick, insulated, and ready for the elements. On the other hand, anatomically, modern humans originated in the warmer tropical climates of Africa. Their lighter body mass and smaller noses reflected adaptations to heat. Their physical features were designed in such a way to maximize heat dissipation and minimize overheating. But the debate over Neanderthal and AMH physiques goes beyond just climate. Variations in body size and proportions along these two species seem to fit these rules to some extent, but there are exceptions. For example, some Neanderthals from Iberia have limb proportions that don't align neatly with the expected Arctic pattern. So Neanderthal body traits might reflect their behavior and lifestyle too. Relatively shorter limbs could suggest adaptations for efficient movement over rugged terrain. Their larger rib cage and nose might indicate a need for greater oxygen intake to support a more strenuous lifestyle. Similarly, their robust physique and higher body mass might point to their hunting lifestyle, which raises another question. How did Neanderthals, with such a varied physique, run and hunt? But before we get to their locomotive adaptations, subscribe to our channel and never miss the heated debates of our primitive history. So AMH is well adapted for endurance running, with features like long lower limbs, a spring-like arch in the foot, and a narrow pelvis that reduces energy expenditure over long distances. These traits reflect adaptations for chasing prey over extended periods, a technique requiring stamina and efficient heat dissipation. In contrast, Neanderthals' shorter limbs and stockier build suggests less emphasis on endurance. They may have relied more on short bursts of strength rather than prolonged running. Their longer heel bone, for example, would have reduced the efficiency of their running stride, possibly making them better suited for short bursts of speed rather than sustained endurance. Neanderthals' hunting techniques were, of course, heavily influenced by their build. They were likely close-range hunters. Evidence of trauma on Neanderthal bones suggests that they were often engaged in dangerous hunts. A study in 1982 compared the injuries found on Neanderthal skeletons to those of rodeo riders, indicating that their hunting style was incredibly risky and involved a lot of physical confrontation. Plus, the hunting area they covered was about 600 kilometers squared. This broad range indicates they pursued large game across wide landscapes. They would hunt different animals depending on the season, such as wild goats in summer and other prey year-round. A study led by the University of Southampton analyzed tooth enamel from Neanderthals and early modern humans to understand their diets and hunting strategies. The findings show that Neanderthals hunted large animals across a vast territory. They targeted species like horses, red deer, and even an extinct rhinoceros. In contrast, the later Magdalenian humans, who lived around 13,000 years ago, had a different approach. They occupied a smaller territory of around 300 square kilometers and focused on smaller prey like rabbits and freshwater fish, alongside some larger game like red deer and wild goats. Their diet and hunting strategy reflected a more restricted range and a shift to exploiting resources in a more localized area. The fossils found in Croatia suggest Neanderthals primarily relied on a meat-heavy diet, with their physique likely adapted to process large quantities of animal protein. And to a smaller extent, they also consumed seafood, plants, and mushrooms. Modern anatomical humans, on the other hand, exhibit a more varied diet that includes a significant amount of plant-based foods. Genetic adaptations, such as increased salivary amylase gene copies, allowed a more efficient carbohydrate digestion. So what can we take away from all of this? That Neanderthals were absolute units. With their short limbs, heavy mass, and apex hunting skills, they were the powerhouse of their time. Yet, as impressive as they were, it's clear that our ancestors, the anatomical modern humans, were just as remarkable, with a build and lifestyle that allowed them to thrive across diverse landscapes. Now, go visit our channel and step into the intricate lives of our ancestors.